Welcome to Cows and Climate. My name is Frank Mitloehner, and I'm a professor and air quality specialist in the Department of Animal Science at UC Davis. So a question that I get very often is, can we eat our way out of climate change? In other words, does what we eat matter when it comes to greenhouse gases, when it comes to overall climate impacts? And the answer is, it matters, but to a much lesser extent than, let's say, policy decisions and large changes that are needed in society in order to really make us come down in our overall carbon emissions. For example, whether you individually change your light bulbs at home, it matters, but to a much lesser extent, but whether your community or your county or your state uses one form of energy over another has a large impact. It is these large scale changes that really drive climate emissions. There's no doubt that all of us can do more to reduce climate pollutants. And that includes the livestock sector. The dairy sector, for example, and I just look here at California, has had drastic improvements in performance and reductions in emissions over the last few decades. They have further pledged 40% reductions of greenhouse gases to be achieved within the next decade. Now you show me any other sector in society that can live up to a 40% reduction pledge. In my opinion, personal action will have very little impact on climate emissions. Whether you individually decide to eat one diet over another, let's say a vegan diet over an omnivore diet, will have relatively small impacts. For example, if you were an omnivore today and you were to decide to go vegan, then that move over a period of 1 year would reduce your carbon footprint by 0.8 tons of what we call CO2 equivalents. 0.8 tons. One fly from the US to Europe generates 1.6 tons of CO2 equivalents, or twice as much as your change from being an omnivore to a vegan. In 2017, a peer-reviewed paper was published on the effects of changes to what we eat on our carbon footprint. What this paper showed was that if all Americans were to go the Meatless Monday route, for example, we would reduce the carbon footprint of the US by 0.3%. Not nothing, something, but I think everybody would agree that number is not very high. All Americans going vegan, meaning no animal source foods whatsoever, would reduce the carbon footprint of the United States by 2.6%. But that would come at a price, because if we were to produce only vegan food, we would not be able to satisfy the nutritional needs of the people in our country. A price I'm not willing to pay. In my opinion, in the United States and other developed countries, there's no question where our focus should be to reduce our carbon footprint. It is the use of fossil fuel responsible for 80% of our overall carbon footprint. What we eat has an impact, but it is minuscule compared to those other effects.